Thank you, Chairman. I'd like to talk about the incidence of spondylolisthesis, spondylolisthesis, and degenerative scoliosis of the lumbar spine in patients with osteoarthritis of the hip. Macklem and the others reported that osteoarthritis of the hip is sometimes associated with spinal lesions, inducing low back pain and leg pain, and named this condition the hip-spine syndrome. This attracted our attention to the relation between hip OA and the spine. We previously reported that hip OA causes alignment abnormalities of the lumbar spine and that limitation of the range of motion of the hip joint caused by hip OA is related to these alignment abnormalities, as well as the narrowing of the disc height. We have experienced a number of such cases in which hip OA was also associated with lumbar spondylolisthesis, spondylolisthesis, or degenerative scoliosis. The purpose of this study is to determine the incidence of lumbar spondylolisthesis, spondylolisthesis, and degenerative scoliosis associated with hip OA. During the period from April 2000 to May 2008, 1,101 patients with hip OA who were admitted to our department for surgery and who underwent two directional radiography of the lumbar spine were focused on in this study. All radiographs were led by a single spine surgeon who determined the presence or absence of lumbar spondylolisthesis, spondylolisthesis, and degenerative scoliosis. Spondylolisthesis was judged to be present when a slip of more than 3 mm was noted on the radiograph lateral view. To exclude non-structural scoliosis, scoliosis was judged present when the curve angle exceeded 5 degrees on frontal view, lumbar radiograph obtained in the supine position. Result. Of the total 1,101 cases, spondylolisthesis was present in 47, giving an incidence of 4.3%. The incidence was equal at 4.3% in both genders. Of these, ischemic spondylolisthesis was not noted in 25 cases for an incidence of 2.3%. Degenerative spondylolisthesis was found in 153 cases for an incidence of 13.9%, while degenerative scoliosis was present in 213 cases for an incidence of 19.3%. Discussion. In hazard conducted investigations on the prevalence of spondylolisthesis in the Japanese general population, Matsui and the others in a CADBA study of lumbar vertebral specimens estimated 5.6%, while Takahashi and the others, like us using lumbar spine two-directional radiography, arrived at a finial of 3.8%, which was similar to that obtained in our present study. With regard to degenerative spondylolisthesis, Takahashi and the others reported the incidence of 3.7% using lumbar spine two-directional radiography, compared to which the rate of 13.9% reported by us here is high. Regarding the incidence of degenerative spondylolisthesis in hip OA, Morimoto and the others have reported a figure of 31%. These are extremely high rates, and since the mean age in our study was similar to that in theirs, no explanation for this difference immediately comes to mind. As a cause of degenerative spondylolisthesis, hormonal factor, systemic flaccidity, and genetic factors common to generalized OA have been proposed. While Morimoto and the others have speculated that the incidence may be high in hip OA patients, since in them, the facet joint morphology of L4-5 tend to be arrow-like. Furthermore, with respect to lumbar degenerative scoliosis, Watanabe and the others found a prevalence in the general population of 12.8%, and Vanderpool and the other 6% being more frequent in the present study. With regard to degenerative scoliosis, regression discrepancy has been reported to be an associated factor, but all of these investigations have focused on the standing position. In the study of Miyake and the others on supine position to exclude non-structural scoliosis, no correlation was noted between degenerative scoliosis and regression discrepancy, Like in the case of degenerative spondylolisthesis, systemic common genetic factor as well as other factors are thought to exert an influence. Conclusion. In the series of 1101 cases with hip osteoarthritis, spondylolisthesis was present in 47 cases, with spondylolisthesis found in 25 cases. In addition, degenerative spondylolisthesis was present in 153 cases and degenerative scoliosis in 213 cases, emphasizing that in osteoarthritis, the incidence is high. Thank you for your attention.